Hey, I'm gonna do one more little thing.
I'm here with boxing trainer Joe Goossen. Fresh, it's Monday morning. It's a holiday, Martin Luther King Day, but the gym is popping. Everybody's training.
That's
like
right.
Every holiday, boxing, no days off, as they say.
That's right.
Wildest DeVern, what did you take from that fight?
Well, you know, we had talked about it, and you know, I liked Wilder. You know, I thought if Stavern could last into the later rounds that he might do more damage, but he really waited to pull the trigger. You know, you got two options when you fight Wilder. Either back up or you go forward, okay? And either way is dangerous, because that guy's got a right hand that can hurt you in any round. You know, there were a couple of rounds where Wilder looked a little out of sorts, that it might be going the other way, and then somehow he pulled it back together and landed the good shots, which impressed me. That right hand is beautiful. I thought Wilder could have really done a little bit more damage if he followed up a little bit more off his right hands. Because if you notice, when he throw the 1-2,
hurt his hand in the fourth round.
His left hand?
His right
hand. Well, I wasn't going to talk about his right hand, even though he threw his right hand. And if he hurt his right hand early on in the fight, he was still throwing it hard because he stunned Stavern later in the later rounds with it several times. But what I was going to say was, when he was throwing his 1-2, if he would have come up the middle with a left uppercut more, because Stavern had his hands up, you know, he had the earmuffs on, and the left hook wasn't really getting to him, but the left uppercut was there all night, and I never really saw Wilder go to the liver much after a right hand either. Now, of course, you're giving yourself up a little bit to the shorter guy if you do that, and you could be countered, but still, I think he'll probably look at that tape and go back and say, yeah, I could have done a few more things, and I might have been able to stop him had I used both hands a little bit more efficiently.
Two fights for Wilder. Wilder, Tyson Fury, Wilder, Klitschko.
Before I go on to that, I do want to say Wilder looked tremendous. I think he's going to learn a hell of a lot from that fight. I really do. I think it taught him a lot. On the other hand, Stavern, just to break it down a little bit, I thought he had the right idea. He went right out and
I was impressed by Stavern.
He challenged Wilder's power by walking right in. He put the earmuffs on. But what he did in the last round is what he should have done from the first round on, which was, instead of just walking stiffly with the hands up, you know, he should have had a little bit more head movement and banged the body more, trapped him more, kept him, you know, boxed in more. He could have done it, you know. But, it's not like he didn't try necessarily, but I think it came a little too late, the type of pressure I was looking for earlier. But I loved what he did. So he blocked a lot of punches from Wilder early, and then when he did get cracked, he took it well. You know, and I think he started hurting Wilder to the body late. You know, again, if he had it to do over again, I think he'd probably start a little bit earlier to the body, and Wilder, if he thinks about it a little bit, could have followed up a little bit more off the right hands.
Wilder,
other than that, it was a great fight.
I enjoyed every round.
Every round.
Very excited.
Yeah, it really was.
I say that Wilder knocks out Tyson Fury in less than a round.
If he gets to him, look, that right hand. It's the first guy that's gone the distance with Wilder.
What's up, Randy?
You know, I'm not an expert on Tyson Fury, but I just think that Wilder probably a lot more to the table next fight. You know, so that's a distinct possibility.
Wilder Klitschko?
The Klitschkos are tough guys, man. They got those right hands just like Wilder does, except they're a lot more experienced. You know, I think, it would suit Wilder good to get a few more fights as champion under his belt. A few bigger guys before he goes and, you know, maybe messes with Vlad Klitschko. But, you know, look, the Klitschkos are pushing. They got to be close to 40, right?
Yeah.